10,000 days, one after another. Counting them at the rate of 1 per second would take you about 3 hours. Living them at the rate of 1 day each day would take you 27.378 years. It is from this idea that we started to build this vision of our near future. We asked ourselves, what will the first 10,000 days of Mars colonization be like? Would it be possible to make well-founded and rational predictions about how it will take place? And we've tried. Every prediction is based on a reasonably optimistic evaluation of the technological and social progress of humanity. Only the most important and innovative events are mentioned. And according to us, the conquest will begin on November 7th of the year 2031 to 2059, the first 10,000 days of the Martian colonization. November 7th, 2031. Two cargo ships separately land on Mars at the two most promising locations for the first human base on Mars, Utopia Planitia and Southern Arcadia Planitia. Both ships have a small nuclear power reactor in cargo and an automatic atmospheric propellant plant to produce oxygen and methane from the Martian atmosphere. The two sites, 400 kilometers apart, were selected on the basis of very restrictive criteria, such as proximity to deposits of water or ice, an intermediate latitude to ensure the contribution of solar heat, and uneven terrain with slopes of less than 5 degrees. After their descent to Mars, in-depth evaluations carried out by two rovers will lead to the final choice of the place where the first human settlement will be implanted, which will provisionally be called Mars Base Alpha. February 2032. After the ground tests are done in both places, the final location of future Mars Base Alpha is selected in Utopia Planitia. 2033. Replenished with propellant derived from the Martian atmosphere, the spaceship that had landed in Arcadia Planitia leaves Mars and returns to Earth in 2035. November 2033. Two other unmanned starships land at the selected location of Mars Base Alpha. A backup ship, which has tested the environmental control and life support system on the way, and a cargo ship with rovers, miner, and tunneling droids, and solar panels for their first human mission. Several landing fields are also cleared and prepared robotically at Mars Base Alpha location for the human mission next month. 2033. Chinese rover lands on Mars to collect samples and launch them back to Earth. December 25th, 2033. On a mission supported by NASA, two SpaceX crew starships with 12 astronauts each land at Mars Base Alpha. First humans on Mars. The crewed ships, serving as temporary habitats, are accompanied by a few cargo ships, including one with machinery for a ground-based in-situ resource utilization system, ISRU, a set of equipment that collects, processes, stores, and uses the material that a planet makes available. 2033. NASA's Research Mars Surface Field Station is established at Mars Base Alpha, a complex of modules used as research centers to coordinate the first wave of Martian exploration. 2034. Solar array is built at Mars Base Alpha to supplement the energy generated by nuclear reactor on board the first cargo starship. 2035. Several space agencies join NASA in financing the scientific operations at Mars Base Alpha and transport of their scientists between Earth and Mars. 2035, two constellations of Starlink satellites with a global positioning system and a global communication system are deployed around Mars. Now, it's hard to get lost on Mars, possibly only in a lava tube or a narrow canyon. 2035, mining of water ice starts near Mars Base Alpha, a ground-based system with an atmosphere separator and chemical propellant plant capable to produce and store water, nitrogen, argon, and liquid methane, and oxygen is assembled. 2036. Several landing and launch pads for future Starship missions are built a few kilometers from Mars Base Alpha. 2036. Martian regolith extraction, chemical separation, and storage equipment is assembled. The useful elements can now be used in the greenhouse and ISRU system. 2036. Second crew of 30 astronauts and workers aboard a starship lands at Mars Base Alpha. The first modular ground habitat and a hydroponic greenhouse are built to provide Mars Base Alpha with locally grown vegan food. 2037. Some of the landed cargo starships and one crew starship with a small crew and some returning scientists leave Mars. Their arrival on Earth is expected after 8 months. 2038. First fully occupied starship with 50 scientists, workers, and colonists land at Mars Base Alpha. 2039. NASA's Mars Surface Field Station is reorganized into an international scientific research base, with scientist crews rotating every Earth-Mars synod, 26 months. 2040. The ISRU capabilities of Mars Base Alpha are extended not only to produce air, water, and methalox fuel, but also steel, bricks, cement, basic fertilizers, plastics, and silica products, as glass panels. Some industrial-sized 3D printers are also assembled. 2040. First orbital fuel depot for Hydrolox and Methalox rocket engines completed at low Earth orbit. The hydrogen and oxygen are provided from the Moon and near-Earth asteroids. The methane, from Earth. 2040. The International Mars Surface Field Station officially declares that Mars does not host indigenous life forms. June 2040. A large amount of cyanobacteria is introduced into the ISRU processes of Mars Base Alpha. We can say that this is the beginning of the terraforming of Mars. July 2040. A fish farm is built at Mars Base Alpha to provide more diverse local food for the colonists. The greenhouse is vastly expanded. 2040. Starships with 97 human colonists and workers land at Mars Base Alpha, which now has a population of around 170. Cargo ships bring in heavy-duty construction and tunneling equipment. 2042. A transparent, radiation-filtering, geodesic dome with a garden is built at Mars Base Alpha. Work begins to build a new underground section with larger habitats and working areas to boost the population capacity of the base to at least 1,000 inhabitants. February 2042. First baby born on Mars. It's a girl, the daughter of two NASA scientists. Her name is Noyes Lambent. Controversies erupt on Earth over the child's likely inability to return to her home planet one day. The Martian colonists reply that, by now, her home planet is Mars. July 2042. Starships with 223 human colonists, workers, and individually wealthy tourists land at Mars Base Alpha. November 2042. First votes to elect an official representative of the Martian colonists. It will remain in charge for an entire Martian year, equal to 668.6 sol, or 680 Earth days. 2042. First expedition to the summit of Olympus Mons, the tallest planetary mountain in the solar system. During the ascent, the first fatal accident occurs. One of the members of the expedition loses their life, sliding on a steep escarpment. 2043. Several small proxy bases for scientific, mining, and other purposes are established within a few tens of kilometers from Mars City. March 2043. Mars Base Alpha changes name. A quick referendum among the 400 settlers decides that provisionally the settlement will be called Mars City. 2043. The new underground section of Mars City is finished. Now the colonists have a lot of spacious living and working quarters with full radiation protection. 2043. Cultured meat farm is built, adding meat, although artificial, to the diet of the colonists. 2043. Virgin Galactic Company establishes the first luxury hotel on the outskirts of Mars City. 2044. On behalf of several space agencies and asteroid mining companies, a Blue Origin manned spaceship reaches Phobos, with the first modules to make the free spaceport of Phobos, intended to serve as a station and fuel depot and repairs for manned and unmanned spaceships to Mars, to the asteroid belt, and beyond. August 2044. Starships with 300 passengers land at Mars City, which now has a population of around 770. Among them, the now 73-year-old Elon Musk, who crowns his desire to go and die on Mars. 2045. Large deposits of minerals with a high concentration of rare metals are discovered a few hundred kilometers from Mars City. A research mining base, Beta, is established. 2045. Robotic water ice mining station is built on Phobos to supply the water and propellant needs of nearby free spaceport. 2045. A land trip all around Mars is completed for the first time. 2045. The landing pads near Mars City, where crew and cargo starships have landed and taken off for 14 years, are transformed into a small spaceport with pressurized sky bridges for both passengers and cargo. It includes several ports also for the newly developed Heavy Starship, the next generation of starship system with a core diameter of 18 meters, more spacious living quarters for up to 200 passengers, and spin artificial gravity of 0.38G, the same of Mars, when in duo ship mode. 2046. First two Heavy Starships, each with 400 passengers, land at the spaceport of Mars City. Cargo Heavy Starships bring parts for a nuclear fusion reactor. 2046. With additional modules arriving and maintained by Blue Origin, the International Free Spaceport of Phobos is now operational. Robotic asteroid mining in main asteroid belt can now rapidly expand. 2046. Blue Origin's lander lands on Mars for a scouting mission to confirm the best location for a Blue Mars base. 2046. First school opens in Mars City. Now it is allowed for children over 14 years to travel to Mars along with their parents. 2047. A public transport route between Mars City and mining base Beta is established. 2047. A short hyperloop line from Mars Base Alpha to its spaceport is finished. 2048. Two Heavy Starships with 400 passengers land at Mars City, and another one with 200, mostly miners, at the mining base Beta. The population of the Mars Base Alpha now surpasses 1,200, with 200 more colonists living at nearby proxy bases and 300 at mining base Beta. 2048. Blue Origin's spaceship fleet with 100 workers arrives at Free Spaceport of Phobos. Workers are shuttled down to establish the Blue Mars base about 1,000 kilometers from Mars City. 2049. A nuclear fusion power station is operational at Mars City. 2049. A new underground section of Mars City is finished, boosting its population capacity to 3,000. 2050. With increased electrical power, the industrial capabilities of Mars City are greatly extended, using the resources harvested, refined, and processed around the city and nearby proxy bases. Solar panel assembly factory is the first factory on Mars manufacturing complex products. Start the Mars economy. 2050. Mars City Police Force established, taking over the policing function in the region from security guards hired by SpaceX. January 26, 2051. Closest approaches of Mars to Earth since the beginning of the colonization. The largest colonial fleet ever arrives at Mars with 100 colonists landing at Mars City, 200 at mining base Beta, and 200 at Blue Mars base. 2051. With China and Russia focusing on the moon, India is the first Asian superpower to establish its own base on Mars. 2052. An international human mission to Ceres, flying with a new generation nuclear fusion spaceship, stops at Free Spaceport of Phobos to resupply, drop some scientists at Mars City, and take additional crew members from Mars. 2053. 1,200 colonists land at Mars City in mining base Beta, and 150 at Blue Mars base. There are now more than 4,000 humans permanently or temporarily living on the surface of Mars. 2053. At an impact crater near Mars City, work begins to build the first large-scale dome on Mars, covering the entire crater more than a kilometer across. 2055. Several more Blue Origin's shuttles land at Blue Mars base, boosting its population to more than 500. Indian Mars colony now has more than 200. 2055. Using its strong presence on the moon in its favor, China also established its own colony on Mars, which now is being expanded fast. 2056. First public suborbital shuttle route between Mars City and Blue Mars base is established. 2056. The large-scale, transparent, radiation-filtering, lightweight dome is finished and pressurized near Mars City. It covers an area of almost a square kilometer. Workers move in now to construct the buildings and gardens with such features as artificial waterfalls below the dome. 2057. New generation of SpaceX's nuclear fusion-powered spaceships arrive at Free Spaceport of Phobos. Passengers are shuttled down to the spaceports of Mars City and Mining Base Beta. Old Starships and Heavy Starships are retired from SpaceX's fleet after 36 years of successful service and sold to several interested countries and companies. 2058. The interior infrastructure of Mars City's dome is finished, having a maximum population capacity of 20,000. 2058. A hyperloop line and heavy cargo train tracks are built between the Mars City and the industrial complex at Mining Base Beta. 2059. SpaceX's nuclear spaceships take more colonists to Mars City, bringing its population to more than 6,000. 2059. First Brazilian heavy starship lands at Mars City. One of the nearby proxy bases is sold to Brazil and expanded with more living habitats. 2059. The United Arab Emirates establishes its first base on Mars, the new Dubai. March 25, 2059. In Mars City, in one of SpaceX's residential domes, Elon Musk dies suddenly at the age of 88. Exactly 10,000 Earth days have passed since November 7, 2031, the date the first starships landed on Mars, starting the colonization.